type 1 diabetes really turns the child's and the family whole life upside down. Their lives, despite the fact that there are technological advances, is changing forever. In the natural history such as that, shortly after diagnosis, there is a period of partial remission of the beta cell, which is the cell that makes insulin. And I thought that if there could be something that could decrease this inflammation in the pancreas and beta cell, then perhaps we could prolong the time that the child is making some insulin. And so I tried to look for medicines that could fit in that category of decreasing inflammation. In this study, it was a study that was conducted not only in Buffalo, in several centers, and we showed that, in fact, Golimumab did preserve insulin production and lower insulin dose. And it also reduced the number of low blood sugar reactions where the sugar reads less than 54. And to give an idea, anything less than 70 is dangerous, but when you approach less than 54, if you are driving a car, you may get into an accident. If you are involved in a sport, you will be pulled out of sport, and it has to be promptly recognized. It's a medicine, Golimumab, that could alter the path towards total demise and death of the beta cell. Right now, this is the first step to publish this data. The medicine is not approved for type 1 diabetes. It gives a message of hope for the parents and children because the insulin dose was very low. And when the insulin dose is low, it's much easier to prevent low blood sugar reactions and have a better lifestyle. I think it's very important that people realize that while this is not a cure, the fact that the child with diabetes is able to be on a lower insulin dose from the pump or the injections, and that the pancreas of the child is able to supplement with his or her own insulin, is making the quality of life of the child much better.